like to present the testimony of a crucial witness. I think this witness may shed light on the name who is continually popping out in all our investigation, the investigation of the Committee on Accounts and Dangerous Drugs, and in the Committee of Public Order, particularly Mr. Michael Young.
Well, what is the relevance of the testimony of this witness of yours, Your Honor, in the issue that we are investigating in the Committee on Drugs?
Kasi, Mr. Chairman, considering po yung ating binabanggit na si Michael Young has been coming out, no, regularly doon sa mga hearing natin. And if you would remember, sometime ata nung, I think, hindi ko alam kung naimbestigahan po ninyo to, but I watched it in the Senate. Ito po yung may kinalaman doon sa magnetic litter, wherein Mr. Asierto mentioned the name of Michael Young. And in that investigation, there is also one personality or one witness who is mentioning the scheme in the Bureau of Custom. And he is present today. And he executed an affidavit, and he is willing to share his story. So if the committee will allow for this person to be present and to manifest his story, then Mr. Chairman, I think it will help us a lot in order to somehow have more a constructive and intelligent discussion on this matter, why the name Michael Young existed in the different committees that we have conducted.
May I know, Chairman Fernandez, who the witness, what's the name of the witness?
Well, he wrote us a letter, and the name of the personality is Mr. Jimmy Guban.
Mr.
Jimmy Guban.
And who is Mr. Jimmy Guban, and what is his relation to the...
He's the one who have said that Eduardo Asierto ay siya ang naging importer noong 6.3 billion shabu that was apprehended in the Bureau of Custom. And according to the affidavit that he has given us, nagkaroon po siya ng recantation last year.
So he recanted his...
He recanted his story, and I think it is incumbent upon us to hear this recantation. Because I think, Mr. Chairman, we will be able to find out why this Michael Young is always in the discussion of the different committees that we are conducting.
Okay. Do we have a copy of the judicial affidavit signed by Mr. Jimmy Guban?
Yes, Mr. Chairman. And I think it was submitted to the Quadcom. And the affidavit that he executed and duly notarized is here with us. Okay. So if I may, I will be reading the portion of the
letter.
Yes, the letter that was submitted to the Quadcom. If I may, Mr. Chairman, no?
Please proceed, Congressman Fernandez. Session resume.
This is the letter, Mr. Chairman, that was addressed to all the chairman of the Quadcom. And it's a long letter. And if you're going to allow me to read the last portion of his letter, which states, "Should you consider me as one of your resource persons, may I respectfully request that I be given immunity from prosecution and placed within the jurisdiction of the House of Representatives or the Witness Protection Program. Considering that my testimonies will cause serious and imminent danger to my life and are self-incriminatory, for your consideration and perusal, I attach herewith copies of my sworn statement containing my proposed testimonies and judicial affidavit containing my retraction of my previous testimonies during the Senate hearing, more particularly my statement that Colonel Eduardo Jojo Asierto has personal knowledge of the importation of two magnetic lifters containing shabu seized and confiscated in Manila International Container Port on August 7, 2018. I think, Mr. Chairman, with this letter that was sent to us, it is imperative for us to discuss and find out the truthfulness of this affidavit, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Fernandez. Where are the copies now of the affidavit, the judicial affidavit of Mr. Guban? Have we distributed copies to our members for today's hearing?
I don't know if the COMSEC have given the copies of the affidavit and the judicial affidavit to all the members. Okay. We can ask the COMSEC, Mr. Secretary, Mr. Chairman.
Okay. While we are reading, we will give all the members 5 minutes to read the affidavits that are distributed to the members. And then thereafter, when we resume, we will propound questions on the witness that will be presented before this committee. May we ask, by the way, Mr. Jimmy Guban is a PDL. He is now under the custody of Bureau of Corrections. And because of his letter to the committee has requested that he be present in our hearing today to be a resource person as well as a witness with his signed judicial affidavit. So may we ask the security to please
the Sergeant at Arms
to escort Mr. Jimmy Guban to this hall. 1 minute suspension.
Our resource speaker who wanted to say something on this quadcom, I think we have to take the administer the oath of this personality, Mr. Chairman. So can you please stand up, Mr. Jimmy Guban, and COMSEC, Mr. Chairman, directly.
COMSEC, please administer the oath to Mr. Jimmy Guban.
Do you swear to tell the truth and nothing but the truth in this congressional inquiry, so help you God?
Thank you. Thank you, COMSEC. I believe the members have already been given a copy of the affidavit of Mr. Guban. And we will proceed with the questioning.
Mr. Chair. Before we ask the some questions, can we allow him to deliver his and explain about the I think the affidavit that I have right now is not yet notarized, but it was it has a signature of Mr. Jimmy Guban, but if I will check the whole 4 pages, hindi pa po siya notarized. So can we ask if we can swear on the truthfulness of these letters that you have sent to this Quadcom?
Thank you, Mr. Chair, Your Honors. Magandang hapon po. Hindi po ako makapag-notarize yan kasi nasa loob po ako ng Bureau of Correction. Pag nag-notarize po, I have to be present. I'm sure si Madam is a lawyer. Kailangan po pag-notarize, present po ako na manunumpa.
Yes, tama, no, Mr. Congressman Fernandez. Dito na lang, sa harapan ng committee ito, ay susumpaan mo na iyong sinulat dito sa inyong affidavit na, inyong pinirmahan ay ang katotohanan at pawang katotohanan lamang.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay, maraming salamat, Mr. Guban. Now, siguro, let us proceed. Bago tayo magtanong tungkol sa kanyang affidavit, eh siguro baka pwede bang malaman yung personal circumstances mo, kung sino ka, ano ang iyong trabaho, at bakit ka nakakulong?
Maraming salamat po mga kagalang-galang na kongresista, the Honorable Chairman of this committee. Bago po sana ako mag-introduce, mas gusto ko po sanang basahin muna ang letter ko po sa inyo para mas malinaw kung ano po ang intention ko dito at kung tama po ang hinihiling ko sa inyo.
Yan
at
bang,
is the last part, Your Honor.
Ang iyong babasahin ang buong kabuuan ng iyong apidabit?
Your Honor, away may request that my case be investigated of this Quadcom Committee. To Honorable Ace Barbers, Congressman Bimbineda Abanti, Honorable Congressman Paduano and Congressman Dan Fernandez, as I am asking Your Honor, at least siguro kahit ito yung last three paragraph, with the forum which this Quadcom will provide, I wish to express my intent to be part of the investigation. And I undertake to tell the truth in nothing but the truth, to shed light on the proliferation of illegal drugs. Should you consider me as one of your resource person, may I respectfully request that I be given immunity from prosecution and placed within the jurisdiction of the House of Representatives or the Witness Protection Program, considering that my testimony will cause serious and imminent danger to my life and are self-incriminatory. For your consideration and perusal, of course, Your Honor, I attach herewith copies of my sworn statement containing my proposed testimonies in judicial affidavit, containing my retraction of my previous testimonies during the Senate, during my testimony in the court, more particularly my statement that Colonel Acerto has personal knowledge of the importation of two magnetic letters containing shabu and confiscated in Manila International Container Port on August 7, 2018. Your Honor, again, magandang hapon po. Sa hearing po namin sa korte, branch, RTC Branch 35 sa Manila, binago ko na po yung statement ko doon. Na ngayon ko din po mailalabas kung bakit ko tinuro si Colonel Acerto para mag-disguise ako. Pero mas mabuti po na ikwento ko ng sunod-sunod para po malaman ng ating mga kalanggalang na kongresista at mga namumuno po sa bawat committee. Dahil ako po ay ngayon pong August 7 is my 6 years nung mahuli po yung magnetic lecture sa custom. September, I think, kung di po ako nagkakamali, was my 6 years when I was cited in contempt in the Senate. Kaya pag binilang ko po, halos 6 years na po akong pinahihirapan sa kulungan. Hindi ko po mailabas ng todo ang aking hinaing. Dahil sa Senado pa lang, pagkahuli namin ng magnetic lecture sa customs pagdating ko sa Senado, tinutukan na ako ni Poncio Pilato. Yan po ang totoo. Nahuli po namin ang magnetic lecter with shabu sa Manila Container Port together with PDIA. Then, kasama ko po si Colonel Pardo, Director of the NCR PDIA. Kasama pa rin po namin si Colonel Acerto. Kami po ang nagbuo nito para mabuo ang malahat at maayos at mahuli ang illegal na druga dahil yun po sa utos din sa akin ng director ng CIS where I belong. Ako nga po pala si Jimmy Guban, intelligence officer ng Bureau of Customs before. Then I was also designated as the chief OIC of the CIS Port of Manila. Ako ngayon ay si PDL Jimmy Guban with prison number 8223P5046. Masama po pala manghuli ng illegal na droga sa loob ng Bureau of Customs. Sumunod lang po ako sa utos ng pamunuan dahil noon po ay katatapos lang natanggalin ang pinuno ng Bureau of Customs. Pinalitan na galing sa PDIA na ang pangalan ay si Commissioner Isidro Lapiña. During the time, Your Honor, operatiba na po ako, organic po akong operatiba ng Customs Intelligence and Investigation Service. That is 17 years. Marami pong inuuto sa akin, marami pong reports na nare-receive namin na still nandoon ang mga tao ng First Family at pati sila ay nag-iimpluensya. During their first few months, Your Honor, malami na pong nawawalang containers. Sa Port of Manila, sa Taguluan, MICP, missing. Even in our intelligence report, we received already about 7 to 10 containers loaded with shabu. Isa ho itong magnetic lifter na isi-swing nila na hinabol namin, inayos ko because I was din chef. May access na ho ako sa E2M. Nakuha po namin positibo, nag-joint press release ang BOC Commissioner at DG ng PDEA sa loob ng Bureau of Customs. It was a good accomplishment. Your Honors, pagdating ho sa Blue Ribbon Committee, nagbago. The night before the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee, may tumawag sa akin, hindi ko kilala, nag-ring ang cellphone. Another ring, may kasunod na text, nagpakilalang si Dismangawang. Dismangawang is our collector, deputy collector during the time sa Port of Manila. Nagpakilala siya, kaya sinagot ko, pero hindi ko kami yan magkaibigan as an employee of the Bureau. Sinabi niya lang, tumatawag sa'yo si Paring Bini. Kausapin mo. Si Paring Bini. I am referring to Mr. Bini Antiporda. Kausapin mo kung ano pa magagawa sa kargamento. Sinagot ko kagad siya. Madam, sorry. Trabaho, huli na yan. Accomplishment yan. Your Honors, pagdating po sa Senado, sa Blue Ribbon Committee, nag-hearing, after the hearing, sinight kagad ako, I was cited in contempt. Dinala ko kagad ako doon sa kwarto. Gusto ko hong magpahinga. Tiningnan ko kung anong pwede kong magawa. Dahil mali pala ang magtrabaho ng tama. May sumunod po sa akin na kumatok. Sabi ko, siguro ko may tutulong sa akin. Nagpakilalang, tiga Blue Ribbon to. Buksan mo pinto, babae. Sana po makuha natin ang CCTV. Nakita ko po, staff ng Blue Ribbon. May sumunod po sa kanyang pumasok, diretso sa kwarto ko. Tuloy-tuloy po akong tinuturo, dinudoro. Jimmy, pag binanggit mo ang pangalan na to, pag binanggit mo to, mamamatay ka. Lalo na kung makarating ka sa Pasay City Jail, di tatagal ang buhay mo. The worst, Your Honor, sinabay niya pa pati anak ko. Alam namin kung nasaan yung anak mo sa Makati. Madali kidnapin yan. Your Honors, alam niyo po ba kung sino yung mga tao na ayaw niyang ipabanggit? Na halos doon palang gusto na ako sipain, bugbugin. Si Pulong, si Mans, si Mike Liang, at ang sabi niya pa, mga kaibigan niya ni Benny, Antiporda, magkakasama yan, hindi mo ba iisang pamilya yan, palagi yan sa Malacanang. Official pa yan ng National Press Club, Press Club. Si Mike Liang, doon ko lang din nga po nalaman. Your Honors, halos hindi ko humatantya na intelligence report namin ay doon palang validated na na may mga trabaho si Michael Yang at ang kanyang kaibigan ng illegal na droga. Halos, sabi ko, Diyos ko, akala ko trabaho lang to. Your Honor, doon pa ako nag-isip. Nag-isip, nanalangin, at sinabi ko sa sarili ko, para safety ako. At alam kong kaibigan ko naman si Kenil Asierto, at malapit sa intelligence report namin, siya na lang ang dinisguise kong importer ng magnetic lifter loaded with shabu. Your Honor, before the time nung ma-apprehend namin yung container, may kasama akong si Hernan Abaryo. By the way, Your Honor, ang may-ari niya na Bicaba Trading, ang consignee na yan, ang may-ari ay Tiga Calapan, Oriental Mindoro. Meron akong kasama na Tiga Oriental Mindoro. Magkasabay, nalaman ko kagad kung sino si Mr. Bicaba Trading, Bidasto Cabral Barakil. Dahil si Hernan Abaryo ay tigaroon, na-check niya kagad kung sino si Bidasto Cabral Baraquel. Ang pamilya ay nandun lang sa, ang pamilya ni Hernan ay tigaroon sa Calapan City. Si Mr. Baraquel ay nagtatrabaho lang bilang traffic enforcer sa Calapan City. Bago ko yan binigay sa PDIA. Inalam at kinausap ni Agent Hernan Abaryo. Umuwi, kinausap, tinawag. Pare, pakiconfirm mo na lang kung meron parating or what. Alam niyo, yung tatlong tao, normal na normal. Parang walang nangyayari sa kanila. At yung isang inchik, dalawa o tatlo, sabi sa akin, pare, yung inchik nga, hindi takot eh. Sabi ko, bakit? Sabi niya, Michael Yang yan eh. Michael Yang yan, advance. Pulong. Kami hingi na lang ng tulong sa inyo, tulong yan. Wala pong kakwinta. Parang hindi po na, parang normal na normal lang. Na yung importation ay kay Mr. Bidas, ang consignee ay Bicaba Trading. Your Honor, yun pong tatlong yun, nakuha po yun ng PDEA. Invited by the PDEA or arrested. It was only presented once sa scene. Umamin sa scene, takan niya yung kargaming to, gamit. Kinakiusapan siya ni Mr. Ponichin. I'm sorry, Your Honor, wala pa akong copy. Nagaling po talaga ako sa Bucor. Nandun po yan, nababasa po yan natin, mababasa at mababasa natin yan. And I can bring that document here. Napakalinaw ng tanong ng chairman ng Magic Blue Ribbon Committee, ah, ng Senate Blue Ribbon Committee. Your Honor, inamin, may ebidensya, yung tatlo lang muna. Bakit nila winala hanggang ngayon? Anim na time po ako nagsasuffer sa kulungan. Ang tokana, double barrel, kunti lang na droga, kulong kagad, patay kagad. Nasaan itong tatlo? Si Mr. Bidasto Cabral Baraquel, Lagrimas Katipan, Emily Lukigan, ang alam ko ho yung inchik, pinakawalan din nila. Ano ang meron? At bakit po ako ang dinibigbig hanggang sa Bucor, nakarating ako na nanghuli lang po ako ng illegal na droga. Wala akong nawala kahit katiting. Inorderan po ng judge na sunugin, sinunog. Nandoon po ang testimonya ng mga PDEA. Kasama kong PDEA sa aking opisina sa Bureau of Customs. Kami po ang nanghuli. Ano po ang particular na batas? Ang iba-violate ko? Conspiracy to import? Or yun ang grand conspiracy na linisin ang pangalan ng First Family at si Michael Yang para pagsalitain pa ako at papirmahin na ang kasama doon sa importation ay isang politiko na kalaban nila na hindi ako pumayag. Dahil sabi ko walang alam yan. Hanggang ngayon po, malinaw. Basahin ko man po ang testimonya ko hanggang ngayon. Magaling pa siguro po ang kunti kong memory card. Hindi ko po makakalimutan kung paano ko sinakripisyohan yan. Ako ho, ikinulong. Buti na lang may Diyos. Pagdating po sa kulungan, may mga tumutulong sa akin. May mga lumalapit ho. Natistigo kung sino si Michael Yang, paano nasunog ang Bureau of Customs, paano pinatay ang empleyado ng mga taga-customs. Bakit ang daming releases during the time ng mga containers na nawawala hanggang ngayon hindi iniimbisigahan? Napakasakit po mga kalagalanggalang na kongresista at sa iba pong mga resource speaker dito. Andito po ako, I am seeking for truth and justice. Nothing less, nothing more. Thank you, Your Honor. Meron pa, pero mamaya naman baka tumasok BP ko.
Salamat, Mr. Guban. Uminom ka muna ng tubig at bago ka namin. Alam mo, Mr. Guban, ang iyong affidavit ay maaari naming tanungin. Nang sa ganun, eh, Kung ito talaga ay ikaw ang gumawa, at kung ito talaga ang katotohanan, eh lalabas naman po yan sa inyong mga sagot.
Yes, Your Honor.
Pwede bang malaman na Jimmy kung ano ang position mo sa Bureau of Customs?
Ako po ay isang intelligence officer 1, as yun po yung item ko. But during the time I was designated as the OIC chief of the CIIS, Customs Intelligence and Investigation Service, Port of Manila.
Ilang taon kang operatiba sa intelligence sa Bureau of Customs?
I was with the Bureau, Your Honor, for 17 years. Hindi po ako umaalis as intelligence operator, intelligence operative.
Pwede bang sabi mo sa committee ito, ano ang rason bakit ka nakakulong?
Your Honor, ang ganda ng intensyon ko po. Dahil sa otos galing sa taas ng bagong administrasyon ng Bureau of Customs, hinuli lang po namin ang magnetic lifter na may lawang shabu. At yun ngayon ang ikinaso sa akin, conspiracy to import ng illegal na droga. At ako po ay dinalhan or nagpresenta sila ng halos 40 o 43 witnesses, kaya 4 na taon po ang proseso namin sa korte. Then kasama po yung TSA, 4 na taon po akong nag-suffer ng kulong habang nag-hearing sa Manila Regional Trial Court.
Pwede bang malaman kung ikaw ang gumawa nitong affidavit na ito? At kung ito ba ay yung pirma? Pwede bang paki-confirm mo?
Yes, Your Honor. With the assistance, kapo, meron ako. Para sigurado tayo. Yes, Your Honor.
Basahin mo muna, Mr. Jimmy Guban, let it be known that by the members of this committee that what you have right now is the actual statement that you were mentioning a while ago. Baka tingnan mo mabuti. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Your Honor, nahalos nasabi ko na to, pero if necessary, nababasahin, babasahin ko po para po sa kaliwanagan.
Siguro, tatanungin ka namin doon sa mga sinulat mo para makita natin kung ikaw ba talaga ang gumawa at ikaw ay nagsasabi ng katotohanan.
Yes, Your Honor. With the help of my lawyer, gawa po namin to. Kaya lang po, sabi ko nga, nagkikwento ako, nasalo po ako ng National Bilibid Prison. Hindi po fresh ang mind ko, pero halos ito na rin po yun. If I may, Your Honor, if I may proceed to read.
Sige, make it very short, Jimmy.
Number, pwede mo ba number 3 na? Number 2. In the early part of 2017, during my meeting with a certain alias Henry, a Chinese national known importing of various goods in Bureau of Customs, he introduced to me Councilor Nilo Abelliera, known as Small Boy. In the said meeting, Small told me that he is the business partner and trusted man of Michael Yang, Pulong Duterte, the son of then President Rodrigo Duterte, and Attorney Man Scarpio, the husband of then Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte. In that, as their business partner and trusted man, he was tasked to facilitate the release of shipment from the Bureau of Customs, which according to him were usually pants and clothes, agricultural products such as sugar, rice, and vegetables, among others. Councilor Small Abelliera requested me not to be strict with their shipment after the meeting. Councilor Small always talked to me over the phone and sought my help in the release of their shipment, to which I acceded. In the meantime, our office received reports from our confidential informants, usually bodegueros and painantes of the shipment facilitated by Councilor Small Abelliera, that illegal drugs were mixed up with said shipment. As an offshoot of said intelligence report, Director Azhar Albani of CIIS Bureau of Customs issued to me a memorandum dated March 2018, re-importation of illegal drugs, monitoring, profiling, recording of imported goods. On account of our intelligence work, various shipments were alerted in various occasions. Small requested me, luwagan mo yung mga shipment na yan. Alam mo naman na kila Michael yan, Pulong at Mans. Said container shipment were reported missing while on hold and alert status. In POM, MICP, yun po yung nabanggit ko kanina, pati po Taguluan. As well as other international ports in the country, prompting the House of Representatives to invite Custom Commissioner Lapiña and to shed light thereon. Between the months of May and June 2018, Colonel Jojo Acierto shared to me an additional intelligence report about shipment of illegal drugs at the Bureau of Customs. In that through profiling, backtracking, and tracing of documents, we were able to find out overstaying cargos, one of which was the Bicaba trading shipment. Upon discovery thereof, I instructed my staff to verify if an importer consigning name Bicaba trading is duly accredited with the Bureau of Customs Accreditation and Monitoring Office. After verification of Bureau of Customs Accreditation and Monitoring Office, it was found out that Bicaba Trading was not an accredited importer or consignee by the Bureau of Customs. Based on the information gathered by our office, Bicaba Trading is owned by certain Bidasto Cabral Baraquel Jr., is in live-in partner Maria Lagrimas Katipan, who are business dummies of businessman importer Pony Chen, and his former wife Emily Lakigan, who are resident of Calapan, Mindoro. I ordered my subordinate Aito Fernand A. Abario to proceed to Calapan, Mindoro and validate said information. While in Mindoro, Aito Abario was able to meet Bidasto Cabral Baraquel Jr., Maria Lagrimas Katipan, Pony Chen and Emily Lokigan. During said meeting, Abario called me and asked me to talk to them by phone. During our conversation, Pony Chen asked me to help release said shipment and said vernacular, "Huwag ikaw matapot kasi sila man Scarpio, Pulong Duterte at Paikilang ang may-ari ng shipment." When it became certain that the shipment of Bicaba Trading was located in the MICP, I reported to General Quinto this fact so that he should request Commissioner Lapiña for the issuance of hold and alert order. That request was approved by then Commissioner Lapiña. On August 7, 2018, when we arrived at the MICP, the container was ready at the designated examination area, ready for its opening. After the container was opened, two magnetic reflectors were found inside container. In the presence of PDIA headed by Regional Director Pajardo and BOC official including General Quinto, MICP District Collector Attorney Bakiran, MICP BOC personnel, the magnetic reflectors were forklifted and taken out from the container. It took some time, however, to open the magnetic reflectors, so I have to go back to Colonel Acierto to inform him about the difficulty in opening them. After a while, Colonel Acierto called me back and gave the instruction, the details of which I also relayed to the PDIA agents in order for us to open these magnetic reflectors. In the afternoon of August 2018, Colonel Acierto arrived at MICP and conferred with Director General Aquino and Commissioner Lapiña. After their meeting, I met them at the warehouse where the magnetic reflectors were opened. They congratulated each other for the accomplishment before presenting themselves to the media. Thereafter, the proper inventory and disposition of these drugs were undertaken. During the Committee on Accountability of Public Officers and Investigation, Blue Ribbon, hearing on PS Resolution No. 425 to conduct an inquiry in aid of legislation into the 6.4 billion worth of shabu shipment from China on the possible malfeasance, misfeasance, in non-peasants of Bureau of Custom Officials. Employees, Senator Richard Gordon, PS Resolution Number 843, directing the appropriate Senate Committee to conduct an inquiry in aid of legislation into the alleged shipment of 6.8 billion worth of shabu is smuggled into the country in the possible lack of coordination among the Bureau of Customs, the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency, and the Philippine National Police, by Senator Emmanuel D. Pacquiao in PS Resolution Number 849 to conduct an investigation in aid of legislation on how a shabu shipment worth 6.8 billion managed to enter the country through the Manila International Container Port and slipped through the inspection of Bureau of Customs by Senator Trillanes, Sonteberos, Drelon, Aquino, and Dilima on September 11, 2018, in which I was invited as a resource person. I was cited in contempt, notwithstanding the fact that I thoughtfully answered the questions propounded on me by Senator Gordon, then chairman of the Blue Ribbon Committee. While I was detained at the detained at the scene. Immediate personnel, he introduced himself as Paul Gutierrez, who worked as a staff of Bini Antiporda, accompanied by a Blue Ribbon Committee staff, came to my room at the scene while I was detained and threatened me. Huwag mong banggitin ang mga pangalan nila, Pulong, Yang at Mans. Alam namin kung saan nakatira ang pamilya mo. Alam din namin na nasa Makati ang anak mong lalaki. After a couple of days, Senator Gordon talked to me in an executive session and advised me to tell the whole truth during the hearing. Otherwise, I will continue to languish in the Senate for a long time. Acceding to his advice, I told him all that I know about the illegal drugs being imported to the country through the Bureau of Customs. However, due to the threats of Paul Gutierrez, I never confided to him that Mans Carpio are involved in illegal drugs importation at various ports of the Bureau of Customs, more particularly the illegal drugs found and seized at MICP. The night before the Senate hearing, my cell phone rang for 3 times, but I intentionally failed to answer said calls. After several calls, which I again did not pick up, I received a text message introducing herself as Ms. Mangawang of the Bureau of Customs. When my cell phone rang again, I answered the call, and the one who called was Ms. Mangawang, and she asked about the Bicaba trading shipment. She asked me anong magagawa dyan sa shipment na yan. Kinaparing Bini Antiporda yan. I replied her, wala na akong magagawa, huli na yan. For fear that my son and other members of my family will be killed, including myself, I testified during the hearing on October 30, 2018. And instead of appointing naming Pulong Duterte, Mans Carpio and Mikey Liang as the owners of the shipment, based on the intelligence reports we gathered, I pointed to Colonel Acerto as the one who has knowledge that the shipment consigned to Bicaba Trading contains illegal drugs. I recanted my said statement against Acerto through my judicial affidavit, which I executed and submitted during the criminal case number R-MNL-19-03472CR for violation of Article 2, Section 4 in relation to 28 and 31 of Republic Act number 9165, of which I was convicted and adjudged guilty as charged and was sentenced to suffer the penalty of life imprisonment and to pay a fine of 500,000 pesos. After promulgation of the decision in the proceed case, I filed a notice of appeal with the Court of Appeals, which I docketed, which is docketed as CA-GR-CRHC-19146. That's all, Your Honor.
Okay, salamat, Jimmy. Congressman Fernandez.
Yeah, Mr. Chairman, ano lang, briefly, ano, medyo, mabigat yung mga tinuran mo, Jimmy Guban, no? I just wanted to make it clear, no? Meron lang akong liliwanagin, kapraso lang to. Kasi nabanggit mo yung nagkaroon ka ng recantation. Kumbaga, hinawi mo yung mga sinabi mo na sa Senado couple of years ago that si Acerto ang nag-import ng mga shipment doon sa custom.
Apo, yes,
at yun ay binabawi mo. Ang tanong ko sa'yo, kailan mo siya binawi?
During my testimony at the court, at the Regional Trial Court of Manila.
When was this?
Your Honor, I think that was only last year.
What month?
October. I was brought in Bureau of Correction by November.
Okay.
October, I think.
October 2023.
Before, Your Honor, yung part na po yan, hindi ko pa po nababasa. Yun lang po yung months na yan, pababa.
Kasi, Mr. Chairman, I want to make it clear that yung recantation niya nangyari noong 2023. And
yes, Your Honor.
The reason why you recanted is why? Because
I want to tell truth already, Your Honor, at the RTC that Colonel Acerto is not the, really the importer of the Sitiabo.
And not because that you have watched that we have created a Quadcom committee, that's the reason you recanted.
No, Your Honor, I was in jail during that time.
Kasi I don't want to make it seem that because of this Quad committee that we created, eh, nagkaroon po siya ng recantation. And I don't want that to be perceived by the people and by us that you have manifested that statement that you have mentioned a while ago because you have recanted a year ago.
Yes, wala, di ko pa po alam yung committee, Your Honor. Talagang totoo lang yung sinabi ko doon sa korte.
Kasi ano, Mr. Jimmy Guban, siyempre natatakot din ang members ng committee na to because you have recanted, no? That, kumbaga, binago mo yung statement mo eh. And how can we be assured that you will not be changing your statement again? Diba? Kaya, siyempre, kanina, medyo nagulantang ako dahil ang dami mo rin nabanggit ng mga pangalan. Nabanggit mo sila Peña, si Tess Mangayon, Benit Abtiborda, Paul Gutierrez, Konsehal Abelaria, Abelara, si Pulong, si si Michael Yang, si Hans, si Mans. So I was trying to jot it down eh. And napuno na itong aking sinusulatan and I'm really confused, no? But of course, this is the statement that you have taken your oath.
Yes, Your Honor.